Welcome at this session number 56 on multidisciplinary approaches for improving sustainable livestock production. And we have two sessions. We have a morning session and an afternoon session. This morning session will be about research needs and opportunities and difficulties. And this afternoon we will talk about user application needs. So it's a full day session, and you have seen that you will be filmed by different cameras. I just mentioned also, for those who do not want to be filmed, please sit in these two rows. If you want to be filmed, go sit somewhere else. We also have a list, we will distribute a list for you to sign so that we have an approximate idea about who came and what your interests are in which session. And with that, we're going to start. So I hope you have a good day here. And so the first introduction will be done by Marie-Lyne Pinard, who is co-coordinator of the SAFIR project. I am Jaap Vermilgen, I'm the coordinator of the Feed the Gene project. As you've seen probably from the program, we have a very strong input from these two projects, because these projects deal with multidisciplinary approaches. But not only these results from these projects, there are also other presentations and posters. We have a morning session and an afternoon session. In the morning, we have a brief introduction by Marie-Hélène and myself. Then we have an invited presentation by Marianne Serre, who's sitting there. You'll see her in a few minutes. A few short presentations with a coffee break in between. And then we have a panel discussion, with some people here on stage, and also a discussion with you about the opportunities and difficulties to do multidisciplinary, interdisciplinary, transdisciplinary research, you name it. So we want to have a discussion with you on that. Then this afternoon we continue with a few short presentations, three invited presentations, and then a few short presentations. And again, a panel discussion about user needs and applications. And also want to stress there are eight posters that were put up in the tent that you could have seen and can still see. Safia, Marie-Hélène.
So in a nutshell, SAFIR stands for Strengthening Animal Production and Health Through the Immune Response. It's coordinated by INRA, by Isabelle Schwartz-Cornil, who should arrive in a minute. And I'm deputy coordinator of this project. It's gathering all the strengths of 14 institutes and in fact 19 labs, five SME, one forum, FAB, who is covering the breeding and the animal production sector, one technology transfer company, one big pharma, Virbac, and all these partners are coming from 12 countries. What are the objectives of SAFIR? It's to generate effective, safe, affordable vaccination strategies, and it's really the name strategies which is important, towards the control of endemic pathogen responsible for economic losses in livestock. So we chose important pathogen which are having a big economic impact. And really in a view of integrated approaches against representative pathogens. So we have been choosing three species, bovine with the bovine respiratory syncytial virus, BRSV. In a pig, we are focusing on PRRS and Mycoplasma pneumoniae. And in the chicken, we are focusing on Emerias species, so coccidiosis, and Clostridium perfringens. So this important, it's really strategies. So to reach effective, safe, affordable, we need integrated approach. And for that, we really need a multidisciplinary approach of livestock infection disease control. Indeed, even if the project is focused on the vaccine design, it's really needs the the expertise of geneticists, biotechnologists, microbiologists, immunologists, pathologists, big pharma, SME, to make it really efficient and applicable. And it needs the input of sociologists, big pharma again, economists, stakeholders, to address the socioeconomic context, to make it pertinent in analysis of infection, disease and control measure. Why? To make it applicable for a transformation of research to market. So with the need, again, of the social ecologists, economists, stakeholders, biologists, mathematicians, who can, for example, model the infection, the risk of infection, the efficacy of the vaccine, to address, for example, at the population level and not only at the individual level and so on. So we need really a multidisciplinary approach. Why? For breeding, for developing innovative integrated health management strategies. What do we mean by that? Again, by combining measures, integrating genetics and biomarker-assisted breeding. You will have an example during this session by Claire Rogel-Gaillard, who will give you some highlights about the result from it. Using schemes based on response to vaccine and pathogen treatments to address this interaction, this complex interaction between pathogens, host disease, and the production system, because we really address it within the production system environment. And we need to include also the management of biosafety, housing, and nutrition, and there comes the interaction with the project feeder genes that Jaap is going to present in a minute. And all together, this is, again, within a socioeconomic context information, and you will have a presentation from Camille Bellet in a minute, on existing prevention and control measures, vaccines, treatment, and genetics, to make it as a whole efficient and applicable.
Okay, I'll continue with a short presentation about a feed gene project. So the feed gene project is about adapting the feed, the animal, and the feeding techniques to improve the efficiency and sustainability of monogastric livestock productions. And in monogastric livestock productions, we are dealing with pigs, poultry, and rabbits. It's funded by the EU for a five-year period, 10 million euro budget, 23 partners from Europe and from China, including 15 partners from the industry and extension services, and 8 academic partners. What do we do? What are the objectives of the project? Well, we work on the feed to develop new feed resources that are not or less in competition with other uses and with food, and improve the nutritional value of feed resources that we have. On the animal side, on the genetic part, we want to use novel traits or identify novel traits indicative of feed efficiency and robustness that can be used in breeding programs and as a selection criterion. And basically the challenge is, especially if you combine feed and the animal, is the feed in the future will be more fibrous, basically be of poorer quality. So how can we do best with something that is of a quality that may be worse? On the animal side, on the whole animal side and animal production side, we work on traits, on models, and on feeding techniques, basically to appreciate variation among animals. I'll come back to that in a minute. We want to develop precision feeding techniques and precision livestock management techniques and evaluate the overall sustainability of the possible solutions that we will propose. Coming back to variation, variation, of course, is the capital for geneticists, and for most other disciplines, variation is basically seen as a nuisance. But I think there's a lot of value in variation, variation among animals, variation among animal production systems. So what we do in our project, and typically what most people do in any action that they undertake, is that they observe variation in phenomena, and we look at variation in feeds, in animals, and the environment. We try to understand that variation. Why is that variation among animals visible? In order to try to predict the variation by using data-driven models, and especially today, yes, there's a lot of data around, we can observe a lot of things, so we can use data-driven models to quantify interactions and to quantify variation among animals. With the ultimate goal, of course, to control, to use that variation, to make best use of that variation, not to eliminate it, but to make best use of it. Now, this session is not just about the projects that we are dealing with, that we will have results of today. It deals with the complexity of multidisciplinary approaches in livestock production. And what we typically do in livestock production, we take inputs, be it feed, be it medication, be it euros or dollars, and we transform that into products, animal-derived products, that are appreciated by consumers. But this is a very straight and linear representation of animal production, because of course we do much more. And these systems that we study, and you will see that, you've seen that the whole week here, they're impacted by climate change, they're impacted by challenges that the animal or the animal production system will perceive and has to respond to. And in the end, there's of course much more, because with animal production, we shape the landscape by our activities. You have here rapeseed, but also the tractor that you see, is that a waste product or is it a resource for agronomy? That can be a different perception on livestock production systems. We use money to make more money. We have farmers that are involved in that livestock production. It's a large sector of employment. And these farmers may have different perceptions to technologies. But of course, we also have to deal with consumers. And consumers are not just people who consume, but they also have the role of citizens when they express their opinion. So all these things we have to take into account. And this makes really indicates why we need multidisciplinary approaches towards livestock production. Now, that is complex, but even sometimes simple systems can be very complex. And what you see here is two hands, one thumb up and one finger like this way. I'd like you to do that. Can you do that? Who could do it? Who did it? You did it? So there are a few people who can do it, but you can see the complexity. It's very simple, but your brain cannot manage it. The good news is this is typically a brain training thing. It is something that you can learn. So if we can learn things like this, perhaps we can learn more complex things. You're a great audience. You're a great audience. And this is going for the panel discussion, this is going to be very good.